Blackie, you're a creature of habit. We have eaten in this restaurant every Tuesday for weeks. Do you know that?
I've got another habit, Mary. I pay the check when we're through eating, like now. Let's go, huh?
I'm ready.
I'd better take you straight home if you want to be there before your cousin arrives.
Oh, well, she'll wait for me, I hope.
Say, there's a cab outside. Run out and see if it's vacant, will you?
Right.
I'll pay the check and be right with you.
I think we have that cab, Blackie. The flag on the meter's up.
Good.
Your check, sir?
Oh, here you are.
Thank you.
And here's your money.
Oh, no, the meal is on the house, Mr. Peterkin.
Thanks, but I'm not Mr. Peterkin.
Ah-ha-ha, but I know better. We're proud to have your patronage, Mr. Peterkin.
I'm not Mr. Peterkin. I'm Boston Blackie, and I'm giving you your money.
And I'm returning it to you, Mr. Peterkin. Please, with the compliments of the house.
Look, I tell you, I am...
You forced me to tear up the check? There. Now you can't pay a check that does not exist.
All right. But believe me, there's been some mistake.
No, no mistake, I assure you. For you, there shall never be a check, Mr. Peterkin.
Now back to Dick Kollmar's Boston Blackie. Enemy to those who make him an enemy, friend to those who have no friends.
Oh, Blackie, you won't forget to get that watch for my cousin, will you?
Don't worry, Mary. The jewelry store is open until 9 tonight. You'll have it this evening.
The one we saw in the window?
Mm-hmm. I think she'll like it, don't you?
Well, if you see one you think she'll like better, get it. You know more about watches than I do.
10-11 Dale Avenue, miss. Here we are.
Hold the flag, driver. I'm going on.
Right.
Don't bother to see me to the door, Blackie. I'll be all right.
You always are. I'll call you later.
Now, you won't forget to get that watch, will you?
Right, Mary. I promise. I'll have a messenger deliver it.
Thanks, darling. Night.
Night. 51 Sunset Parkway, driver, and step on it.
You don't have to tell me where you live, Mr. Peterkin.
What did you call me?
Mr. Peterkin, Mr. Peterkin.
Now, wait a minute.
And if you think this haul is going to cost you anything, you're wrong.
Now, look here,
for the... It's a pleasure to have you in my cab, so there's no charge. Not for the famous Mr. Peterkin.
Good evening. I'd like to see a watch, please, like the one you have in the window there.
I think you mean this one, don't you, sir?
Yes, that's it.
It's a lovely thing.
How much?
$90, sir, but naturally...
Naturally what?
Naturally, there'd be no charge for you, Mr. Peterkin.
Now, wait a minute. My name is Boston Blackie.
You're very modest, Mr. Peterkin, but I happen to know who you are, and I'm proud to give you this watch.
I tell you, I am not Mr. Peterkin. I'm Boston...
Now, please, Mr. Peterkin, I meant no offense.
Look, this is the third time in the last hour that someone has called me Mr. Peterkin. I am not Mr. Peterkin, and I am not accepting the watch without paying for it. Here's $90.
But I couldn't take the money from Mr. Peterkin.
Maybe you can't take it from Mr. Peterkin, but you can take it from me. And take it from me, you're taking that $90. Here. And do me a favor, will you? Believe my name is Boston Blackie. Do you understand?
Of course, I understand. Your name is Boston Blackie, Mr. Peterkin.
Oh, Mary, the watch is beautiful. You shouldn't have done it. You really like it, Trudy?
Like it? It's the most beautiful watch I've ever seen. But you've certainly spent a lot of money on just an ordinary cousin.
I haven't spent it yet. Blackie got it, and I haven't paid him for it. And besides, you're not just an ordinary cousin.
Oh, it's lovely, Mary.
Oh, I told Blackie not to have it engraved for you. Until after you'd seen it, that is. Now, be honest with me, Trudy. Is it really the kind of watch you like?
Oh, who wouldn't like a watch like this?
Well, all right, then. You can have it engraved this evening. Blackie said he got it at Brandon's. That's not far from here. We can run right over.
Oh, I'd like to, Mary, but my train leaves at midnight, and there are some things I have to do downtown before train time.
Oh, I see.
I'll have it engraved when I get back.
Well, all right. I guess that...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.